Yo, what's up everybody? It's your boy Floss, back again with another video. And today we're going to do a quick comparison with the Samsung Galaxy Note 4 and the Apple iPhone 6 Plus. Now, shout out to everybody who watch my videos. You already know, when I say quick, that means about 20 to 30 minutes. So sit back, make yourself a drink, roll something up, get comfortable, and let's get it popping. Alright, so what I did was, I broke this up into a bunch of different categories, some of the main categories that I like to focus on when I'm buying a new phone. Alright, now this is no specs. We're not going to talk about specs in this video. You already seen 1001 spec videos. If you don't know the specs, just Google it. Alright, we're going to talk about real-world usage, all of the shit that people really want to know. So let's get started. First off, the price. Which one has a better price? Well, both of these phones off contract is going to run you over $700. Now, if I gotta pick a winner and loser, I'm gonna go with the Samsung Galaxy Note 4. And also, keep in mind, there's no real winner or loser in this comparison video. It's all about which one you like best. Alright, the purpose of me making this video is to help you out when you're gonna buy your new phone, just to give you an idea of how I feel as an everyday user. I use both of these phones every day. Alright, so there's no winner or loser, but I gotta pick one, so I'm going with the Galaxy Note 4, and let me tell you why. When you buy yourself a Samsung Galaxy Note 4 for $750, you're going to get a 32 gig Galaxy Note 4. Now, keep in mind, this has a upgradable storage. All right, so you could drop an SD card in here and upgrade the storage. So now, if I got a 32 gig Galaxy Note 4 for $750, all I got to do is go in my house, get one of my old micro SD cards out, slap it in there. I could go on Amazon, I could buy a 64 gig card, slap it right in there, and upgrade the memory. When you buy your iPhone 6 Plus, you're stuck with whatever you get. So if you buy a 16 gig iPhone 6 Plus and you run out of space, you're going to have to start moving everything to the cloud. You're going to have to start deleting stuff. You're stuck with 16 gigs. All right? You can't upgrade the memory. So when it comes to price, I'm going with the Note 4 simply because you get more for your money. All right, you drop an SD card and you get more memory with an iPhone 6 Plus. Now you can get a 128 gig iPhone 6 Plus, but it's going to run you almost $1,000 off contract. So when it comes to the price, I'm going with the Note 4. Next. The build. Which one has a better build? Now, both of these phones, in my opinion, have a quality build to them. But if I got to pick one, I'm going with the iPhone 6 Plus. All right, both of these phones, like I said, great build. But when you're holding the 6 Plus in your hand, now keep in mind, without a case. Once you put a case on either one of these phones, they feel exactly the same. I got the same UAG case for both of these phones. If I put a UAG case on and I got both of these phones in my pocket, When I reach my hand in my pocket, I can't tell which one is which. They both feel the same. But now for everybody who likes to rock their phone butt naked, raw dog with no case, this one just feels better in your hand. Now, I hear a lot of people say that iPhone 6 Plus is a lot more slipperier. Yeah, that's true. But I prefer the slipperier aluminum feel as opposed to the sharp edges on the Note 4. All right, the Note 4, if you're holding this without a case, you're going to feel these sharp edges. And after a while, if you're holding it for more than 20, 30 minutes, it's going to start to get annoying. Simple fix, just drop a case on it. But we're talking about raw dog phones, no cases. I like the iPhone 6 Plus build a little bit better. Has that unibody aluminum feel to it. And right now it's cold outside, so when you pull this phone out, the phone gives you that, you know, you have that cold aluminum feel to it. Feels nice. Nice and smooth. Also, the buttons. The buttons on the 6 Plus, you see you have these hard clicks. You get the hard click buttons. I'm definitely a fan of that one switch button to switch from vibrate to sound. That's definitely a plus. I've always loved that on all of my iPhones. You know, nice buttons. All right, so when it comes to build quality, both top of the line builds, but I'm going to go with the 6 Plus. Now, the Note 4, you do have the plastic back, but, you know, it's removable. So we'll talk about that in a minute. That's a negative and a positive. Plastic back, yeah, it feels, you know, it doesn't feel the same. Feels like that fake leather, but you can take it off. iPhone 6 Plus, no removable battery. All right, so when it comes to build, let's go with the 6 Plus. Now, display. Which one has the better display? This one is, this is a no-brainer, hands down. Like I said, even without talking about specs, without talking about, you know, UHD and quad HD displays, if you don't know what none of that bullshit means, all you have to do is look at it with the naked eye. All right, when you're looking at these phones side by side, the Galaxy Note 4, the screen blows away the 6 Plus, blows it away. All right, in my opinion, now I got a bunch of other phones too. In my opinion, the Galaxy Note 4 has the best display out of any phone that I got right now, even better than my LG G3. And that display is banging. All right, so when it comes to display, let's go with the Galaxy Note 4. naked eye, just looking at it, you're going to love it. Next, which one has the best battery? Now, like I said, this is a double-edged sword right here. If you're going by just day-to-day use. Now, I use both of these phones before I did my real review on each of them. I put the other one away. I didn't even have the Note 4 yet, but I just put all of my other phones away and I use the one phone as my main go-to phone for the day. Each of these, both of these for a week straight. I gotta say the 6 Plus has a better battery. Now, you could easily argue that, yeah, the 6 Plus has a better battery because the 6 Plus does less stuff. There's less stuff to do on your 6 Plus. You're not multitasking with split screen windows. You don't have widgets running in the background and all that. So of course, the all Android phones, they tend to drain battery more than other phones, more than our Windows phones, more than Blackberries, more than iPhones. Android operating system tends to drain a lot of battery. Now they will fix that with this, I forgot what they call it, Vault, My Vault or something like that. Hit me up in the comments if y'all know. With the Nexus 6, they're gonna fix the battery life issues. But right now, just between the Note 4 and the 6 Plus has a better battery. All right, if you're rocking the 9 to 5, you're gonna get a full 8 hours. Pretty much a full 8 hours out of your 6 Plus. You're not going to get 8 hours out of your Note 4. Even with your 6 Plus, it depends. If you're like me and you're an internet warrior, online beast, you're not getting 8 hours out of no phone. All right? But I get more with my 6 Plus. So battery life, I'm going to go with the 6 Plus. Next, which one has better speakers? Well, when it comes to the better speakers, I'm going with the Note 4. Now, even though the Note 4 has the speaker on the back, which I can't stand that placement, and the iPhone 6 has a speaker on the bottom, I don't like that placement either. I prefer HTC M8 speakers on the front or the Nexus 6 speakers on the front, whatever. I prefer those better, but when we're dealing with just these two phones right here, I'm going to say the Note 4 speaker is louder. Now, neither one of these speakers have quality bass, you know, so you're not going to be sitting around bumping music at your desk, having a little office party. It's not going to happen. But when it comes to just hearing your ringtones, hearing music, watching videos, which one is just louder? The Note 4 speaker is louder. And even with the speaker on the back, when you lay both of these flat on the table, the Note 4 is going to be louder. And especially when it comes to these ringtones. All right, if you're one of those people and you work outside, maybe do construction, whatever you do, and you like to have your phone going off so you can hear your alerts, you're going to hear them with your Note 4. You hear them with your 6 Plus 2, don't get me wrong. It's a nice quality speaker. But like I said, I got to pick one. I'm going with the Note 4. Next, which one has a better camera? All around camera. We're talking about video camera, front facing camera, and the rear facing still picture camera. All right, which one has a better camera? Well, when it comes to camera, I'm definitely going with the Note 4. Now, you see my camera test for yourself. Both video cameras are a go. All right, both of these video cameras are banging. But the one thing that separates the Note from the 6 Plus is the sound. When you listen to the sound, watch both of those camera tests for yourself. Listen to the sound on the Note 4. All right, the Note 4 had a better video camera and also a better front-facing camera. All right, ladies, if you're into taking selfies, and dudes too, you know what I'm saying? Some of y'all selfie cats out there, if you're into taking a whole bunch of selfies, you're going to like the front-facing camera better on the Note 4 than on the iPhone 6 Plus. Now, even without going into specs, who cares about this one having 1.7 and 2.0? Don't care about megapixels. I'm talking about when you take a picture and you upload it to Instagram or you upload it to Facebook, which one looks better? It's going to be the one from the Note 4. Now, on a side note, the 6 Plus does have a better slow motion camera. All right, so if you got a lot of little kids running around and you're constantly at basketball games and baseball games or wherever you at and you like to do little slow motion clips here and there, you're going to have a lot more fun with the 6 Plus slow motion. It just looks better. Note 4 has slow motion too, but the 6 Plus slow motion just looks better. Now, which one is easier to use as far as camera-wise? Yeah, the 6 Plus is way easier to use, but you have less features and less options. All right, so if you're heavy into photography and you like messing with the ISO and the white balance and all that stuff, you're going to want to get yourself a Note 4. Next, the UI. Which one has a better user interface? I was going to say interference. Amazon word tonight, Stream Gangsters, you already know. I'm already about to get turned up. Which one has a better UI? All right, so when it comes to UI, I'm going with the Note 4. Personally, I like Android UI better than iOS. For a few reasons. First of all, when you got an Android phone, you get more animations. You see on your iPhone, when you scroll, everything is simple and plain and clean. Yeah, and it works. It's clean, simple, plain, and fast. When you got your Note or your Android phone, you see how you have different transitions, different animations. You could change those. This is card stacked. You can change the carousel. You can change to whatever you want on your lock screen. Let's go to the lock screen real quick. Look at the lock screen. You see, you have all these fancy lock screens you can do. Just more animations. It's just a lot more all around fun. Also, you have your widgets. No widgets on your iPhone 6 Plus. You have actual widgets that work. Got my flight track widget right here. Now I'm scrolling from behind the camera. Let me see. Did I set this up? Oh, I didn't even set this one up. But you got your Facebook. You got your Twitter widgets. Let me show y'all real quick. Just in case some of y'all cats don't use Android phones, so you might not know what I'm talking about. Let me show you real quick what I mean by those widgets. Because I got it set up on my S5. You see, you got your Facebook widget that actually works. You got a Twitter widget. You got a Google Plus widget. You got a whole bunch of widgets that actually work. All right, so when it comes to the UI, I'm going to go with Android because it's just more fun. It's more usable. Look at another feature like this. When you scroll down from your notification, you have all your toggles right there. Now, on your iPhone, you can scroll up and you do have some toggles, but you can't change these. You're stuck with these five toggles right there. You can't put them in any specific order. If you don't need airplane mode, why do you have to have that as your first choice? You should be able to switch that. On your Android phone, you could easily go and change, put these in any order you want. You can switch these. Like, these are the ones I use the most. If I didn't like car mode, I can move that to the bottom, and I could put power saving mode to the top. So now this way, when I scroll down, I got my power saving mode right there. All right, so when it comes to the UI, I'm definitely going with Android. It's more user-friendly, and it's more usable. Not say user-friendly as far as being easier to use, but it's more usable. You could do more stuff with it. Let's put it like that. Next, features. Which phone has the most features? Well, that's a no-brainer. We got to go with the Galaxy Note 4. Way more features. Let's talk about a few of the features real quick. Now, you already see my real review, so I don't got to go too deep into all of them. But let's talk about some of the features that iPhone 6 don't have and the Note 4 does have. All right, if I said that right. First off, IR Blaster. Now, some people don't care about IR Blaster. That's because you don't have it. But if you have an IR Blaster, you're going to use it. So when I get in the house and I get in the bed and my girl's in the bed watching some Lifetime movies, crying and all that, when the commercial comes on, and fellas, you know what I'm talking about. When you're in the bed and your girl is watching a movie, she's not trying to let go of the remote so you can check the sports score real quick. She's not going to let you switch to ESPN. She want to see that movie. So now when you got your IR Blaster, who cares if she's holding down that remote? All you got to do is go to your Samsung Watch On, go to your remote control app, turn the channel. And not to mention, a lot of times in the middle of the night, you fall asleep. Maybe the remote is out the bed and it's freezing cold. You don't feel like getting up. You got your phone underneath the pillow. Pull out your phone. Change the channel. IR Blaster's a go. Not to mention any room that you're in the house. When you go into a different room, you go in the living room and maybe your daughter, your son took the remote somewhere. You can't find it. You don't have to make a big deal. You pull out your phone. You can use the remote control on any TV in your house. So IR Blaster's a definite go. NFC. Now, we had this big thing. Shout out to everybody on Google Plus. We had this big thing going on the other day on Google Plus. A lot of cats saying that, yeah, the iPhone 6 does have NFC. Yeah, it does. But it's not true NFC. It's not true NFC. And what I mean by that is, yeah, it has NFC. It has the feature for it where you can use Apple Pay and all that. But it doesn't have true NFC. You can't set up NFC tags in your house like you can with your Note 4. So when I go into my office, all I got to do is tap it to the NFC tag. All of my ringtones pop up. Everything gets live. When I get in the car, tap it to the NFC tag. Goes into car mode. You know, when I'm ready to go to sleep, tap it to the NFC tag next to my bed. Everything goes on vibrate. You know what I'm saying? So NFC tags, that's a big deal. Not to mention Bluetooth speakers. You see all the new Bluetooth speakers coming out. NFC tag pairing, which makes it a lot more simple. So now all I got to do is tap and pair. All right, so NFC, that's a big deal to me. If you don't like NFC or you never used it, then who cares? But NFC, that's a big deal. All right, multitasking, that's another feature you could do on your Note 4 that you can't do on your iPhone 6 Plus. For instance, let's open up a multitask window real quick. Let's go to YouTube. Let's open up a YouTube page real quick. Matter of fact, let me do a split screen instead. Let's open up a YouTube. Now, while I'm watching a YouTube video, and this is one of the main features that I love about the Note 4, let's turn on a YouTube video real quick. Now, while I'm watching this YouTube video, I could be in the bottom, checking my emails, responding to my emails, checking my calendar, doing a whole bunch of other stuff. while I'm watching this YouTube video. All right, so that's a win right there. So when it comes to features, the Galaxy Note 4 has 1,000 more features than the 6 Plus. And we didn't even talk about the S Pen. We don't have to. S Pen, that's another feature in this whole, another whole world of features right there with your S Pen. All right, fellas, if you got a Galaxy Note 4, trust me when I tell you, even if you don't like using the S Pen, start using it and get used to using it, and you're going to love it. Let me show you a little feature that I just found out about the S Pen that I didn't even know. I'm just playing around and it happened to pop up. Now, I'm going to cover this number up real quick. Now, the other day, let me see if I can block this out. All right, the other day, I'm on the phone, right? As you can see, while you're on the phone call, you can pull up your memo pad and take a quick number, and it'll store right in that number. And I'll talk more about that later, but that's just another little feature I just figured out. Nobody knows everything. I just figured that out, and it works tough. All right, so now every time I'm on a phone call and I want, maybe you got a number you don't really need to save into your contacts. You know, you don't plan on calling that number every day or every other day. You just might want to call it one or two more times. Save it right to that little memo pad, right into your call log, and save it like that. That's a hot feature right there. Next, let's talk about lag. Which phone has the most lag? Well, what's the most lag, or shall I say the least amount of lag? Well, when it comes to lag, everybody knows that Android phones, especially Samsung phones that run with TouchWiz, gonna have more lag than an iPhone 6 Plus, than basically anything on the market. All right, so now I hear a lot of people saying that Android lags. No, it's not Android that lags. It's when you put another skin on top of Android, that's what's gonna cause the lag. So if you got a stock Android phone like a Nexus 6 or Nexus 5, you'll notice that you got zero lag. But when you got an Android phone that's running Android OS, and then you stick TouchWiz right on top of it, TouchWiz happens to be one of the heaviest skins out. If you see HTC Sense, that doesn't lag at all. TouchWiz has a little bit more lag. Now, when I did that real review, I kept the phone stock. So a lot of people were saying, oh, you know, the Note is lagging like crazy and all that. You have to remember that I'm a power user. Okay, I got 30 web pages open on my web browser. I got 30 other web pages open on Google Chrome at the same time. I'm also running 10 apps. I got all of my widgets. I got 10 email addresses. Every social media site on the block is on my phone running at the same time, and I kept the phone stock. Simple fix. All right, now what I did was, and we'll talk about that for a second. If you got a Galaxy Note and you don't want it to lag, real simple fix. All you have to do, number one, is turn off your S voice. All right, so when you tap the button, matter of fact, I'll show you how to do it real quick. Let's go to S voice. All right, go to your S voice, go to settings, and just simply turn it off. All right, turn off open via the home key, turn that off. So this way now, when you're running around on your phone, you're going to notice it lags less. Now, if you want to get even more deeper into that, all you have to do is go to developer options. If you don't know how to get to developer options, just go to your build number, tap it 7 times, developer options gonna pop up. When you go in developer options, scale down these 3 scales right here. All right, window animation, transition animation, and animation duration scale. Now you can scale them down to 0.5 if you want, but I say turn them off altogether. Once you turn them off altogether, you're gonna notice that your phone is running super fast and no more lag. All right, super duper fast. So that's how you got to do that. But now, iPhone 6 versus Note 4, which one lags the least? iPhone 6 Plus, of course. No lag on the iPhone 6 Plus at all. Now, one thing that you will experience with your iPhone 6 Plus is force closes. All right, now you get a lot of force closes on your iPhone 6 Plus. Now, granted, a lot of these apps, they aren't optimized for the 6 Plus just yet. But still, force closing is just as bad as a lag. You know, if you're driving around and you get to a red light and you got a second and you want to check something real quick, you want to check your Google Plus messages real quick, and you pull up your Google Plus and, you know, you're checking the message real quick and the phone force closes, all that's going to do is you're in the middle of that app, it's going to bring you right back to the home screen. That's the same as using a Galaxy phone and the phone freezes for a minute and you got to hit multitasking bar and you got to close everything out. It's the same exact thing. You're going to start from fresh again and then go back to the app. So lagging out and force closing, two issues that I don't like, but which one is better? I would say the 6 Plus has least amount of lag and least force closes. Now, my Note 4, I hardly get any force closes. Matter of fact, I don't think I ever got a force close yet on my Note 4, but I did have some lag. All right, but now that I scaled everything down, tweaked all the settings, I get no more lag on my Note 4. All right, but if I had to pick one, I would go with the 6 Plus in the lag factor. Next, multitasking. Which one is better for multitasking? Well, you've seen the demonstration I just did. I don't have to do it again. The Note 4 is clearly the best for multitasking. All right, now, when you want to multitask on your iPhone 6 Plus, you could do it, but you're going to be doing stuff like this. So, say I'm watching a YouTube, and I want to go to my Gmail. All right, fine. I could go to Gmail, and I could double tap and go back to YouTube. You're not going to be doing both at the same time. You're going to be double tapping and going back and forth. All right, so when it comes to multitasking, the Note 4 is a beast. It's definitely the best. Next, fingerprint scanner. Which one has the better fingerprint scanner? Now, as you can see, I don't even use the fingerprint scanner on my Note 4 because it's not 100%. Now, don't get me wrong. I would say it's about 95%, but that 5% is big for me. I need the phone to open every single time. And when using your iPhone 6 Plus, you're not going to have that problem. Every single time you rest your finger on that thing, it opens up. Now, I'm behind the camera, so I'm trying to look at it, but let me just look at it for real now. When you look at it and you put your finger on there, it's going to open every single time. Now, I set my Note 4 up with 3 of the same fingerprints. I showed you how to do that in the rear review. And like I said, it works 95% of the time. But if you got a case on your phone or you just happen to do it too fast or too slow, it's not going to work. You're going to have to swipe it again. And some of that is because you have to actually swipe. So no two swipes are never going to be the same. When you're laying your finger down on a button, it's always going to be the same. You just lay it right down. So whenever you have to swipe, yeah, you might get a fast swipe or a slow swipe. It might not open. It might open. Whatever. So when it comes to fingerprint scanner, yeah, I'm going with the 6 Plus as the best fingerprint scanner on the market right now. Okay? Next, ease of use. All right, which one is easier to use? If you never had a smartphone before, or maybe you just had a BlackBerry for the last 3-4 years, and now you're ready to upgrade into one of these big giant smartphones, which one is going to be easier for you to use fresh out the gate? It's going to be the 6 Plus. All right, the 6 Plus is going to be a lot easier to use, less features, less options, less learning curve. All you have to do, this is more like a plug and play kind of phone. You go to settings, everything is right there. Everything is pretty much simple, basic, and clean, but it works. All right, now, people, we could have this argument back and forth all day. Some people say that, you know, people that use Android phones and, you know, you get into rooting the phones and all that, they're more advanced users than people who use iPhones. Well, you could say that if you want. I'm not going to touch that right now, but Android phones are definitely a little bit more advanced than our iPhones. All right, when you get into all the features and the settings and you want to get into Dalvik and Art and all the crazy stuff that you could do on your Android phone that you can't do on your iPhone, yeah, you got to be a little bit more advanced. So when you're first stepping into the smartphone game and you just want a phone that you're going to, you know, play your Facebook and play YouTube and get on Twitter, Instagram, and you're going to be, you know, just browsing the web here and there, then get yourself an iPhone 6 Plus. You're not going to have a problem learning how to use it. Right? Now, you're not going to have a problem learning how to use the Note 4 either, but you're going to have a lot more learning curve. You're going to have to get more stuff to learn and more stuff to memorize. That's why a lot of people, they get scared of the S Pen because they don't really use it. They don't know about all the features. That's why I say use it. The more you use it, the more you're going to get comfortable with it, and the more you're going to realize that you can't live without it, like me. I can't live without my S Pen. Next, accessories. Which phone has the better selection of accessories? Everybody knows that's the iPhone 6 Plus, the iPhone 6. Whatever iPhone you got, you're going to have a wide variety of accessories because this is probably the number one selling phone in the world. So all of these manufacturers, all of these different companies, if you go right now on Amazon, you're not going to have a problem finding the iPhone 6 Plus case. There's a million different cases, and this phone just came out. So imagine after Christmas, there's going to be a million different battery charge cases, a million different docks and stands and wireless charging solutions and all that stuff. You're not going to have a problem. Same thing with the Note 4. Don't get me wrong. This is probably the number two biggest phone out right now. You're not going to have a problem finding accessories for the Note 4. But like I said, if I had to pick one, which one has the most accessories right now? It's simple. All you got to do is go look online, go on Amazon and put in iPhone 6 Plus accessories and then put in Note 4 accessories and watch the difference. All right, the 6 Plus has way more accessories. Next, and now keep in mind, that might not be important to you, but that's important to a lot of people. If this is going to be your one phone that you're going to get and you're going to buy it and you're going to keep it for 2 years, then you want to make sure you have a nice selection of accessories. A lot of people went out and they bought a OnePlus One. And then you go on Amazon, there's only 5 or 6 different cases that you could buy. There's no docks, no stands, you know, not too much aftermarket stuff. So now you're stuck with a phone, you're stuck with those same three cases. If you're like me and you like to switch cases all the time, that's something that you're going to want to think about when you're buying your next phone. So either one of these phones, you're going to have a nice selection of cases, but you're going to have more with the 6 Plus. Next, fun. Which phone is the most fun? Which phone can you have the most fun with? That's important. Phones ain't all about business and emails and all that stuff. Phones are also about fun. It's also about multimedia, watching videos, watching movies on your phone, doing stuff, you know, having fun on your phone. Which phone are you going to have the most fun with? And that's going to be the Note 4. And that's partly because of the S Pen. When you get used to the S Pen, you're going to be making your own memes. You're going to be copying and pasting all over the place. You're going to be taking screenshots and drawing a little bubble and writing words on it. You're going to be blocking out, you know, somebody send you a text message, you can block out some of the information that you don't want the other person to see and forward it to somebody else. You're going to have so much fun with the S Pen. Now, what I like to use my S Pen for a lot too is I use my couple app. You know, my girl's at work, I'm at work, we'll play tic-tac-toe, we'll draw each other little love notes and shit, you know, so it's all right, you know what I'm saying? You don't gotta be hardcore 24/7, sometimes you could be a lovey-dovey shit, play tic-tac-toe, have a little fun, but you're gonna have more fun with your Galaxy Note 4, and like I said, that's because of the S Pen, that's because of the micro SD card removable storage. You could just have a whole, right now I got a whole SD card full of all Family Guy episodes. So now if I want to, all I got to do is pop out the SD card, slap it in. I can watch a whole bunch of movies, pop in the next card, watch a whole bunch of shows, do whatever I want. It's a lot easier to use your Note 4 to have fun than your iPhone 6 Plus. Now the iPhone 6 Plus, you'll have fun with too. Don't get me wrong, it's a big, bright, colorful screen. You got 1,001 apps, probably the biggest app market in the world. So you're going to have fun with all the apps and all that. But just from using it day to day, I tend to have more fun using my Note 4. And last but not least, one of my favorite categories, the floss factor. Now, what is the floss factor? If you've never seen any of my videos before, that means when you pull out your iPhone 6 Plus, when you pull out your Galaxy Note 4, and somebody comes around and you know you're sitting at the bar, you're at dinner, wherever you at, and somebody has their HTC One M8, somebody has an iPhone 6, somebody has an LG G3, somebody has a Galaxy S5. When they pull out your phone, are you still a big dog on the block? Are you still sitting on top of the food chain? Or do you look like you got a phone from the Stone Age? You know, does your phone have that wow factor? All right, so the floss factor is basically the wow factor. So which one of these two phones has more of the wow factor? Well, this is a close one now. Both of them have a wow factor. When you pull out either one of these big giant phones, yeah, especially at nighttime, it's going to look like you got a mini tablet in your hand. It's going to look nice. But when it comes to the wow factor, I'm going to go with the Note 4. Because the display on this is just that crazy, especially at night. If you never tried this, put your phone on maximum brightness and pull this out at nighttime somewhere. It's going to look crazy. Not to mention, when you got your phone out and then you got your S Pen out and you're sitting around somewhere and you're writing on the screen and all that. Somebody walked by and it looks like you got, you know, remember the old school PDAs and you were just writing stuff, but now you're cropping and pasting, you know, copying stuff over, making your own memes and all that. You're sitting around using the S Pen. You just look like a boss. Right? That's plain and simple. You look more like a boss with your Note 4. And not to mention, keep in mind that more people are going to have the iPhone 6 Plus than the Note 4. You know, that's just how it is. I mean, look at the sales numbers. They speak for themselves. More people are going to be running around with the 6 Plus. So whenever more people have something and you have two flagship devices and more people have this one's going to stand out more. Because when you go to the airport, when you go to the DMV, when you go to the deli, you go to the barbershop, everybody got an iPhone, a 6 or a 6 Plus. Everybody got one, even the little kids. A lot of little kids. My daughter got an iPhone 6. Everybody got an iPhone 6. You're not going to be really shining. You're not going to be standing out. Everybody don't got a Note 4. All right, now they got the gold Note 4 coming out, the pink one. You could get custom colors. I'll probably get this one done up some kind of crazy red and black. Who knows? But it's just, to me, it just has more of that wow factor. And like I said, now keep in mind, these are just my personal opinions, all right? There's no right or wrong. You know, my opinion is not facts, all right? My opinion is just my personal opinion as a day-to-day user, At the end of the day, you gotta make your own choice on which phone you wanna get. So I hope this video helps in some kind of way when you know, and you got $700-$800 in your pocket and you're ready to go out and buy a new phone, get yourself a Note, get yourself an iPhone 6 Plus, or you could wait a couple of days and get yourself a Nexus 6. Now, we're going to get into that phone next. I see that phone. Personally, I still think let me just answer this real quick too, before I even get into that. At the end of the day, if somebody asked me right now, which phone would I choose? If I could only choose one phone, which phone would I choose to walk out the door with, go on vacation, you know, go to work for a whole week straight, do whatever I'm about to do, but I can only take one phone, which phone would it be? Well, it would be the Galaxy Note 4, without a doubt. That's because of the removable battery. Now, of course, y'all seen on my channel, y'all seen me do 1,001 battery charges. You know, getting power on the go is not a big deal. It's no problem. But a lot of times, you don't have time to plug your phone in and sit there and let it charge. You know, you want to just, you know, switch your battery and let it go. So now with your Note 4, you got a removable battery. So all you got to do is go on Amazon. You buy these aftermarket batteries, $25, $30. They come with a charger. You charge them up. Now you walk outside with two batteries in your pocket and one in your phone. I don't care how much of an internet warrior you are, three batteries is going to get you through the day. Everybody knows the Zero Lemon battery is going to be coming out soon. Shout out to people who've seen my Zero Lemon Note 3 battery, 10,000 milliamps. Even for an internet warrior like me, I was charging my phone every other day. So that removable battery, that's a big deal to me. You got IR blaster, micro SD card, the S Pen, multitasking, better camera, more features, more fun. I mean, if I had to pick one, it's real simple for me. I'm going with the Note 4. Now, when I did the real review, a lot of people, let's just address this too real quick. A lot of people were saying, you know, you did the Note 4 video, that you know, in the video, that phone lagged out a little bit. But at the end, you still said that was the best phone that you got right now. How is that possible? Simple. Look at it. Just look at it as you look at anything else. You know, if you buy, the other night I went to a car show. Now I'm out there with the fellas. We at the car show. You see all the Lamborghinis, Ferraris, BMWs, Mercedes. You know, anything you can name, it was there at the car show. The Bentleys, Aston Martins, everybody was there. The best car that I seen there was my man rolled up in the McLaren. That was just my opinion, that was the hottest car there. Now keep in mind, that car you're only gonna get 4 or 5 miles a gallon. That ain't good. You know, that car has no back seat. That ain't good. But at the same time, it's still my favorite car that was there. Just because there's something about something that you don't like doesn't necessarily mean that it can't still be your favorite. So even though the Note 4, what might have a little hiccup here and there, you might lag out here and there, that those cons do not outweigh the pros. All right, so out of all the phones I got right now, I could comfortably say that the Note 4 is my favorite. All right, so like I said, hit me up in the comments. Let me know what your favorite phone is out. Keep in mind, the Nexus 6 is coming out, but I still don't see that being my favorite phone. Even though, you know, I like bigger. You know, bigger is better in my opinion. So that 5.9 inch screen, that's definitely going to be a win. Speakers on the front, that's going to be a win. Stock Android, you know, Lollipop, that's going to be a major win. Zero lag. Still, without the S Pen, I don't see it taking the top spot from the Note 4. All right, so let me know what y'all think. Shout out to everybody that rock with me on Facebook, Foursquare, Twitter, Google+. Shout out to all the Google gangsters. I see y'all holding down that Facebook page. Shout out to everybody hit me up on Voxer. And a special shout out to everybody rocking with me on Instagram. Y'all know that's where I'm at full time, 100% full throttle. And it's Sunday night. Shout out to everybody who rocking with the Amazon Warrior. You already know the drill. Get your drinks ready. Stream Gangsters on deck. Oh yeah, one more thing before I get out of here. Fellas, ladies, say it with me. All y'all haters, all y'all trolls, close your eyes and picture me rolling. It's your boy Floss, I'm out. Deuces.